holding his best. I'm about to send two to his dome.
Just actually all of it. The thrill of maybe getting caught and just putting your foot to the floor, almost willing your car to go faster on the highway or on the street, you know, because you're kind of, you don't go, you don't go, you don't go, you don't go.
So he constantly works on his vehicle, trying to coax more speed out of it. Though he's paid pretty well as a computer consultant, his tricked out Trans Am guzzles nearly every dime he brings home.
The intake here, roughly those are about $150. I think I paid about $100 for that, the math airflow meter. So that was roughly $200, the heads and the cam. That ran me roughly about $6,000.
Chris figures he spent nearly $90,000. And it's always a struggle to make ends meet.
And it's always a struggle to make ends meet.
We don't have savings. No, we don't have a college fund. No. And you're dropping $2,500 a month into the Trans Am.
Yep. You don't go. You don't go. You don't go.
That $2,500 a month that he spends on his car,
you don't go.
What kind of place do you think that could get you?
I could have a 6-bedroom house. Easy.
Instead of a 6-bedroom house, Chris, Jenny, and her 5-year-old son from a previous marriage make do with a 2-bedroom apartment. It isn't just the noise. Jenny says if Chris is challenged on the highway, he'll race, no matter who's in the car.
We know it's, we don't try to talk about it, kind of makes us nervous, kind of takes the focus off. I mean, as long as we're focused, we're fine.
Caller, tell me why. Can you get that?
Line five.
Bussing in right here, please. Suck a.
You don't go. You don't go. You don't go.